seconds before the alarm started sounding, which was bad news since we were practically on the doorstep of what we recognized earlier was a barracks. Like someone flipped a switch, the world got turned inside out. Guys came pouring out of the doorways with weapons in hand, looking a little confused but clearly heading to assigned positions. So these guys had some procedures, but everyone has a plan until they start getting mowed down by a Gatling gun. I was watching to see how they reacted. It was a small piece of the puzzle that would be valuable in the future. Things started happening fast after the alarm went off and shit started to pile up.
Access delivery service, what do you need?
A clear path.
I'm on it.
This was going to be super sketchy, since the last 100 meters or so was a fatal funnel between the wall and the church, the latter of which may serve as decent cover as we move to the exit. I'd never burned a church down in an entire career, but tonight might be the night. It was an option, and I'm always about options. There's an old saying, friendly fire isn't, and mortars are no exception. I was guessing these would be something in the 60mm category. I'd seen a lot of M57s in use throughout the country. They were rugged and easy to use by small units, but had pretty basic payload, so I figured these were likely going to be a conventional HE round. Inaccurate as fuck, but the shrapnel doesn't care and it would ruin us out in the open. So I had this on my mind, and getting spotted was yet another problem to add to our growing list.
We need to be out of here in 5 minutes or we're gonna be drowning in hate.
There was so much going on, but it wouldn't take much to get their attention since we weren't only just dressed differently, we were also running in the opposite direction of everybody else on the base. I immediately regretted not making better use of those fresh bodies in their clothing, but I guess Andy's guys, whoever the fuck they were, may have taken shots at us too. To her credit, we'd have been pinned behind the barracks if we'd spent the time changing our clothes instead of bugging out, which we had better get back to doing.
Hey, Puke, friend on Evo.
Think you can still drive an AK?
Fuck, I can.
We've got about 10 minutes before reinforcements show up, and we do not want to be here, guys.
There are no reinforcements coming to dig us out of this mess. No air support or ammo speedballs. Grabbing weapons off dead guys is an option I was exploring, but we needed to be careful with that. Being low on ammo, with 1 foot pointed towards the door, was pushing us in the right direction. It was a great motivator that forced us to concentrate on extending to safety.
Wax, buddy, I need you to start killing people down here in a mad minute.
That was good news, since it should pull some attention away from us.
Okay, what's the bad news?
That was the bad news.
What's the good news?
Though in most circumstances, the church would be the last place I'd be looking to seek shelter, it was the best option that we had. It was between us and our exit point and should give us the opportunity to break contact, if we could even get there. There was a lot of open ground between us and the entrance, and we'd be severely exposed if we pulled back to it. We were all pissed off, all wanting to rip off a piece of flesh and chew on it. Our focus needs to be on pushing out to break contact, full stop. Turns out hunkering down in the church was a great idea, but not particularly original. HE rounds were no longer an issue, but getting pinned in the middle of a church full of bad guys wasn't exactly an upgrade. Santa Muerte is normally associated to healing, protection, financial well-being, and assurance of a path to the afterlife. But the rate we were going, that path was going to be paved with shell casings and bodies, including ours if we didn't eagerly and enthusiastically make our way for the exit. Alright, well, we're out. Over the wall and heading back along the cliffs towards where Wax said he was positioned. He gave us some basic cues and we got back to him as quickly as the rock base would allow. Our original layup point with our civvy drag and larger rocks was in defilade from all the fighting, so we traversed the ridge carefully to retrieve it. There was no going back to the van, so we were on foot until we secured something else. We had a moment to collect ourselves back at the layup point, grab a drink, count mags, and check ammo. I took that moment in time to have a no-bullshit conversation with Andie. What the fuck, over?
I can elaborate later, but these guys came to break me out. I didn't know it was going to happen so soon, but I guess word travels fast.
We going to meet up with them now? Tell them you're okay?
No, they're more about shooting first and asking questions later. I'll have to let that whole thing play out and follow up with them when they're not killing everything they see.
It was time to beat cheeks and put some space between us and that base. We were going to need to stay close to the ridgeline and boogie. We kept moving until the church was out of view, went another half a click, then settled down for a conflab. We went to ground and fanned out to cover the position, covering equal arcs.
Get me to a phone and I can make a lot of your problems go away.
It took me a few seconds to mull that one over. I take it you understand why that idea rubs me every way but right.
Well, yeah. Look, there's a lot of overhead here, Puke. There are just so many pieces to this at so many different levels. You guys only ever had a really small chunk of it, and that was mostly a distraction. I don't have a key that unlocks the whole thing to reveal all the reasons why you need to trust me right now. I know we barely know each other. You have every reason to be suspicious. But here I am, still carrying a loaded weapon, and you've all got your backs turned to me.
She didn't see my eyes go really wide at that realization. Wax, Hotmail, and I traded looks like hockey cards. Talk about tier one flopperators.
I know you probably shouldn't trust me given the circumstances. This has, it's a trap, spray painted all over it. But you all do, so get me to a fucking phone.
Okay, so we get you to a phone. What's next?
Well, if you're uncertain, just get me close. Bug out and go about your business. Okay, sarah, sarah. Nothing lost, but also nothing gained. We probably never see each other again, and if we do, I can't promise the rules will be the same.
Okay.
Maybe we can work something out longer term. I can use your help. I can really use your help, and I think you can use mine.
Do you know what happened to us?
Yep.
Do you know why?
I have detailed files.
Give us a minute. I stepped away with the boys. Wax was facing her, but probably by accident. I mean, she'd called us out. Paying attention now is practically pointless. She'd made a great point, and go ahead and call me a sucker for a hot woman with shit in her pants, but I trusted her. With that said, I was only one part of this team, and the other two might be looking at it another way, and I had to be open to their perspectives. On top of it, we're still missing BLT. Alright, boys. It's been a crazy morning, and right when I think I've seen it all, we turn another corner. Look, whichever way this goes, it's going to impact all of us. Judging by the way things have been going, it may be inside out for a while.
So I need to know.